Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss two concepts. The first one, evolving standards. Second one, other issues. So now we are going to discuss the first concept called evolving standards. Evolving standards means what are the different standards evolve for wireless sensor networks in personal area network environment. For the IEEE 802.15.4 evolve low rate wireless personal area network standards, which investigates a low data rate solution with multi months to multi year battery life and very low complexity. So that means, so IEEE 802.15.4 proposed a standard which contained low rate wireless personal area networks, which investigates mainly on low data rate solution, which must be support for multiple months and for support multiple year battery life also, and it's used mainly for very low complexity, and it is intended to operate in unlicensed international frequency bands. So to support such type of standards, the potential applications of these standards include sensor networks, home automations and remote controls. So by using, so what is the standard proposed by IEEE in 802.1514, the low rate personal area network which supports multiple months and multiple year of battery life. So and working in unlicensed international frequency band, which some example components are sensor networks, home automations and remote controls. What are the remote controls we are using in our homes regular life? So they are all comes under these standards. And home automations, for example, some sensor networks are there to open the doors and to switch on the lights whenever obstacle is entered into the home, and switch off the lights whenever the obstacle going outwards. All these standards are derived, comes under this standard, and this 18 and this standard is also mentioned as 18th draft of this standard was accepted in May 2003 by IEEE. And this standard defines the physical and MAC layer specifications for sensors and other wireless personal area networks. So it also defines the physical and MAC layer specifications also. And low power consumption is an important feature targeted by this standard. So this standard, the most important concept is only low power consumption. This standard requires reduced transmission rate, power efficient modulation techniques and strict power management technique such as sleep modes. So the main importance of this standard is low power consumption. For that they are using a technique called sleep mode. And the next point is different network configurations and topology were compared, and star and mesh networks were found to be favorable for this network standards, for this low power consumption standard provided by IEEE. For these different configurations and topologies are tested and compared, in that only star and mesh networks are found as a favorable network topology for this IEEE standards. And other standards under development including SENSE IT project by the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, which focuses on large distributed military systems, and Zigbee alliances, which addresses industrial and vehicular appliances. So other standards which are underdeveloped, it's nothing but SENSE IT project for Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, which is focuses mainly on large distributed military systems, and the Zigbee alliances is used for industrial and vehicular appliances. So these are the standards evolved around wireless sensor networks. This is our first concept. The second concept is other issues. So in wireless sensor networks, some issues that are recently being explored in sensor networks, those are five different types of other issues are existed. In that, first one, energy efficient design, and second one, synchronization, and third one, transport layer issues, and fourth one, security issues, and last one, real-time communication issues. Among these five other issues of sensor networks, today in this video we are going to discuss only first two issues. That's nothing but energy efficiency design. Come to the first concept of energy efficiency design. This energy efficiency design are broadly classified into two levels. First one, node level, and second one, network level. Then if you come to the first one, node level. In node level, there are two energy efficiency designs are exist. They are, first one, dynamic power management, and second one, dynamic voltage scaling. Then come to the first one, dynamic power management. It's shortly called as DMP. So dynamic power management means one of the basic concept it used to shut down several components of the sensor nodes when no events takes place. That means in dynamic power management, it manages the power by the sensor nodes to shutting down the several components of the nodes whenever there is no any event takes place. So this is the concept of dynamic power management. Then the second energy efficient design in node level is dynamic voltage scaling. So it is shortly called as DVS. So this concept is nothing but the processor has a time varying computation load. Hence the voltage supplied to it can be scaled to meet only the instantaneous processing requirements. That means, for example, in our systems, nothing but if you take sensor nodes also, the processor has time varying computation load. So at one time it computes large amount of data, and in one time it computes small amount of data. Based on that, the voltage is supplied to it and to meet only instantaneous process requirements. So based on the process, the voltage is supplied to that. So this supply may be perfectly maintained by real-time task schedulers, should actively support DVS concept by predicting the computation and communication load. So based on the real-time schedulers, they support more by dynamic voltage scaling. They're predicting the computation and they're predicting the communication load. Based on that, they're supplying the voltage to the processors. And these sensor applications can also be trade-off between energy and accuracy by performing the most significant operations first. So always sensor applications can also be trade-off between energy and accuracy. But even though these sensor nodes can perform most significant operations first, then goes to the other things. So this is the concept of energy efficiency design in node level. Then goes to the second level called in network level energy efficiency design. Or the first point is in network level is the computation communication trade-off determines how much load computing is to be performed at each node and what level of aggregation data should be communicated to neighbor node or base stations. So in the network level, first the node trade-off between computation and communication, that means how much load is computed in the local nodes in each node and what level of aggregated data is communicated between the neighbor nodes or base station. So we want to find out that one based on that energy efficient design. Then second point is traffic distribution and topology management algorithm uses the redundancy in the number of sensor nodes to use alternate routes so that energy consumption all over the network is nearly uniform. So that means network level, so each node, how they are computing in the local environment of each node, and what are the level of aggregating data is communicating between the nodes or base stations. Between the nodes or base stations, based on that the energy efficiency is designed. Then the second point, based on the traffic and topology management algorithms. So if the traffic based number of redundancies is created, based on the other nodes, alternative routes can be identified to transfer the data. Due to that, energy consumption is distributed uniformly to all the nodes in the network. So this is nothing but energy efficiency design of network level. Then come to the second concept. So this is the first concept. Then come to the second concept in other issues called as synchronization. Synchronization among nodes is essential to support time division multiple action schemes on multiple hop wireless networks. That means synchronization means all the nodes in the network, they must be synchronized, they must be connect with each other. So that synchronization is more important. So there are two major kinds of synchronization algorithms are exist in the wireless sensor networks. Those are, first one, long lasting global synchronization, and second one, short live synchronization. So long lasting global synchronization is exist in the networks to provide entire network lifetime. So for throughout the network lifetime, the long lasting global synchronization is useful. For only short period or instant of time, if you want to synchronize the networks, you can use short live synchronization process. Then synchronization protocols typically involves delay measurements of control packets also. The delay experience during a packet transmission can be split into four major components. In the synchronization protocols, the delay experience during a packet transmission can be split into four major components. Those are nothing but, first one, send time, second one, access time, third one, propagation time, and the last one, receive time. So what is meant by send time? First one, send time means sender to construct a message, how much time they are taken, that comes under send time. Then access time means taken by the MAC layer to access the medium. That means how much time the MAC layer is taken to access the medium is comes under access time. Then propagation time means taken by the bit to be physically transmitted through the medium over the distance separating the sender and receiver. Between the sender and receiver, a bit, how much time it taken to transmit in the medium, that time comes under propagation time. Then last one, receive time means receiver receive the message from the channel. To receive the message from the channel, how much time is taken by the receiver, it comes under receiver time. So these are the four major components are involved in delays experiments in synchronization protocol. Now the next point is, many existing synchronization algorithms for sensor networks obtained through GPS. So many synchronization algorithms for sensor networks are obtained through GPS only. We know what is meant by GPS, global positioning system. With the help of this global positioning system, the existing synchronization algorithms for sensor networks are obtained. And the accuracy of time synchronization provided by GPS depends on the number of satellites observed by the GPS receiver. The accuracy of the synchronization is also depends on how many number of satellites the GPS receiver observed. Based on the number of satellites, the accuracy of time synchronization is also defined for GPS. GPS offers an accuracy of 1 view per second in the vast cases. In the very difficult and vast cases, GPS offers an accuracy of 1 view per second only. So that's why GPS not suitable for buildings and basements, underwater, satellite unreachable environments. So wherever the satellite signals may not be reachable, there GPS, global positioning systems are not suitable to support wireless sensor networks. Then there is another concept called forced factor synchronization. In synchronization environment, it supports low power synchronization. So forced factor synchronization supports low power synchronization scheme. So the low power synchronization scheme also called forced factor synchronization. This forced factor synchronization has been proposed by LSAN and S-Trim for wireless sensor networks. This forced factor scheme contains the locks of the nodes are normally unsynchronized. That means this forced factor synchronization supports a type of concept called short-lived synchronization. So in that concept, always the synchronization of the lock of a node are normally unsynchronized. The nodes are in unsynchronized mode. When an event is observed, a synchronization pulse is broadcasted by a Biocon node. With respect to each, all nodes normalize their timestamps for the observation of the event. That means initially all the nodes are in unsynchronized manner. Whenever an event is observed by the node, sensor node, synchronization pulse is broadcasted by a Biocon node. That means a specialized node who know their location. Such type of nodes have become Biocon node. That node, if observed any event, it broadcasts the synchronization pulses to all the other nodes. So that all the nodes normalize their timestamp for the absorption of that event. So this scheme offers short-lived synchronization. So short-lived synchronization means whenever it required for the synchronization, then synchronizing all the nodes. Otherwise, in other time, it is not synchronized. It is in unsynchronized manner. So this scheme, so whatever the concept we discussed under post-factor synchronization, this scheme offers short-lived synchronization, creating only an instance of synchronization among the nodes which are within transmission range of that Biocon node. So who are synchronizing under this scheme, they must be within the transmission range of this Biocon node. The propagation delay of the synchronization pulse is assumed to be same for all nodes. So the concept of post factor synchronization supports short-lived synchronization concept. So short-lived synchronization concept means whenever we require synchronization among the nodes, we make them into synchronized. In other time, they are unsynchronized manner. The delay is also same to all the nodes. So this is the concept of forced factor synchronization, and it supports the scheme of short-lived synchronization. Then come to the next concept of global synchronization protocol. So this global synchronization protocol is proposed by Yoram-Ofk based on exchange of control signals between neighboring nodes. So this global synchronization protocols always based on exchanging control signals between neighboring nodes. A node becomes a leader. So to exchange these control signals in the network, any one of the node become leader when elected by majority of nodes in the network. So in the network, one node may become as a leader elected by majority of nodes in the network. Then that leader then periodically sends synchronization messages to its neighbors, and these messages are broadcast in terms to all nodes of the network. So in the global synchronization systems, they simply exchange control signals between the neighboring nodes with the help of a leader. The leader is elected by the majority of nodes in that network. So always the leader periodically sends the synchronization messages to all its neighbors, and those neighbors broadcasting that one to all the other nodes in the network. And with this broadcasting message, we are adding fault tolerant technique also for errors in the synchronization messages. And including to the fault tolerant technique, this global synchronization protocols approach scheme supports long-lasting global synchronization concept also. So for this, whenever network, wireless sensor network is there in that. Due to mobility, the nodes can be moved from one place to another place. That's why there is a major problem for synchronization between the nodes. So to overcome that problem, we have a concept called resynchronization. So resynchronization is the process of synchronizing different network partitions that are independently synchronized to different clocks to a common clock. That means due to mobility concept, the sensor networks may be divided into some different network partitions. Inside of the partition, the clocks, that means the nodes, are independently synchronized. With the help of this synchronization, those different clocks may come under a common clock. That is the concept of this point. In dynamic networks such as sensor networks, frequent changes in topology make resynchronization as an important issue. So due to the mobility concept in sensor network, resynchronization became most important issue. Then resynchronization takes place in situation such as the merging of two partitions due to mobility, when all clocks in a partition may need to be updated to match the leader of the other partition. That means whenever resynchronization takes place in a situation, that means merging of two partitions, that means two different networks, when all the clocks in that partition may need to update to match the other partition clock, then only we can synchronize them. So resynchronization is the most important concept which is required in sensor network to make them to merge one network. So this is the concept of resynchronization, and this is the diagrammatic representation of resynchronization. For example, first come to the point, a total network which may have only one clock. So due to the mobility problem, the nodes may move from one place to another place. When they are moving from one place to another place, they created some different partitions. So partitions due to mobility. So partition 1, partition 2. When they are divided into partitions, so all the nodes in the network, they move, some nodes move in one partition, some nodes may move in another partition. So in partition 1, those nodes are all creating a clock and they synchronize their own. And in the second partition, what are the nodes in that, their clocks are synchronized. So like these types of partitioning, if you want to make them into a complete network, resynchronizations must be required. So resynchronization or merging, when you merge these two partitions, then again the same type of network will be created. When doing this merging, the clocks must be updated and make them into suitable for the next other node, other network leader must be suitable to the clock which is in this partition. So in that manner, resynchronization concept is existing. So the concept of resynchronization means nothing but whenever a whole network is divided into some partition due to mobility, they have their own clock synchronization. When you want to merge such type of partitions into one, the clocks wants to update and they become suitable to compatible with other partition clocks. So if it is possible, then resynchronization may be existed. So this is the concept of resynchronization. The other balanced three concepts may be discussed in next video. So based on what are the concepts we discussed in this video, based on that, here the assignment questions are given.